count on. NBC2 News at 11.
It takes years to save $140,000, and a Cape Coral man lost it all in seconds.
And there's no getting it back. And let's be honest, the legal system don't care.
He thought he was closing on a house, but ended up wiring all that money to a scammer. Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Brenna White. Tonight, NBC2's Hope Salmon is helping you make sure you're not sending your money into the hands of a thief.
You found the house of your dreams and you're ready to buy it. Now imagine getting an email from a fake title company asking for a down payment and wiring the bad guys the cash. On Tuesday, this happened to someone in Cape Coral. They are now out $140,000. They only found out when the title company asked where the money was.
And when you're talking about a hundred and something thousand, you're talking about a pretty penny to lose.
And scams like this are a little too common.
They'll send us links all the time, like that'll act like they're closing instructions. We get them from our own underwriter. They spoof emails. I've emailed myself.
Laura Carruthers is a closing officer. She says she avoids scams by staying in communication with her clients, warning them of the tricks.
Have a relationship with who you're doing business with. They were wiring to a bank that we used to bank with, so the people there knew us. And when she sat down and handed her the wire instructions, the lady looked up, she's like, are you dealing with Laura? And she's like, yeah. She's like, these aren't their wire instructions.
Emails from scammers can look almost identical to the real one, but don't be fooled by the minor details. Call your title company before sending any money.
Travis Robinson says he gets so many scam calls and emails that he double checks everything.
Even when I use Zelle, I'll send somebody a dollar first and I'll call them. Did you get that dollar? I don't care about losing a dollar, but when you start losing hundreds and thousands, it adds up quick.
As for the person who was scammed, there's no guarantee that the title insurance will cover the money. Reporting in Cape Coral, Hope Salmon, NBC2.